If you have played awesome games like The Forest or Son of the Forest, you might have noticed how smoothly the level of details, LOD, transition happen. It's so seamless that sometimes you can't even tell when the LOD changes. I have been thinking about this for a while, especially since in the Unity engine, models often change without any crossfading or LOD fading. Take a look at this bush. Usually when the LOD changes, it either slowly becomes invisible or fade out. So how can we create something like that? It's simple, just follow me and I will show you how to achieve this using Shader Graph or Amplify Shader Editor. Start by creating an empty game object, attach the LOD group component to it, and then create some default meshes or use your own. While crossfade is supposed to enable a smooth transition between LOD levels, it often doesn't work as expected. So disable animate crossfading and let's create our own shader. This approach works across all pipelines. Enable alpha clipping and set it to 0. Create a custom function using Unity's shader variable, Unity underline LOD fade, which tell us when an object should fade out. Set up LOD fade as a single float output, set the type to a string and name it to get LOD fade. And in body write this code, which sets LOD fade if Unity's value is greater than 0, indicating that we should fade out. And feed it into the alpha. Select crossfade as the fade out mode, but disable animate crossfading. If you click on each LOD, you will see a fade transition with a slider set to the width to 1. And LOD 0 will smoothly transition to LOD 1 through its entire range. Drag the camera icon to get a look. If you set it to 0.1, the transition will begin to fade through the last 10% of its range. You can edit this width independently for each LOD level. As you saw, we get a smooth fade out, but we can do more to make it better. Use the leader node and screen position to create a checkerboard pattern. Be cautious not to set the crossfade width too high, as it could impact performance gains achieved using LOD in the first place. Now I have imported a tree from SP3, you can implement the same technique. Thank you. copy the default Unity shader, make edits, export the tree material, and set it to the new one. Open the shader graph and follow the same step as before. Here, just because it uses the billboard for alpha, we need to multiply it by detail result with this opacity. Adjust the alpha clip threshold. If you are using Amplify Shader Editor, the process is similar. I have demonstrated this using a package called the Vegetation Engine. You will have see the same custom function in the shader with a float output named LOD Fade. In Amplify, there is no need for a screen position in the detail node. Simply multiply the result by alpha and clips. That's it. This is the difference between the default crossfade and the custom approach we have created. Thanks for watching. I hope it was helpful. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe to the channel to see our next videos. See you next time.